I'm back with another one-roll review of a film that I tried for the first time. The film is Orwo's Wolfen NC500, and I shot it in my Leica MA during winter last year. As you can see, it's quite unique to say the least. I didn't mind my results, especially some that I shot in the snow. I shared some of these samples in a short video that I released earlier on the channel. If you want to check out the experience and more results from my Pentax 645N, I'll put a link for that in the description. I found that NC500 is grainy, cool, and desaturated. I thought some of the results were a little bit too grungy, and I wasn't the biggest fan of it compared to regular film stocks, but I recently decided to rescan the roll with my camera and convert it using NLP, and I liked the results a bit more. It took the edge off and showed more of the dynamic range than was showing through on the lab scans. But I'll show more of those comparisons later in the video. For now, here are more of my initial lab scans, which were made with a Fuji Frontier SB500. You can see that the film is quite desaturated, especially in the shadows. It has an overall cool cast and prominent grain structure. I think that blues come through the strongest on this film stock compared to anything else, but it really seems to depend on the scene and the lighting. I exposed my roll at around 200 or so, leaning towards overexposure as usual. I did use Sunny 16 for many shots, so this is just an estimate, but it was still clear that overexposure works better than underexposure on this film, as with all color negative stocks. I accidentally underexposed some shots, and you can see the shadows deteriorate very quickly. I tried overexposing a shot further as a test, and although it held up, I wouldn't suggest overexposing more than two stops with this film. In high contrast scenes and lighting, when exposing for the highlights, the contrast and saturation came through nicely, giving a look that I quite like, especially in the home rescans. These street shots kind of remind me of vintage slide film. And I hate to say it for fear of sounding cliche, but it kind of reminds me of old Kodachrome. So if I was to ever try this film again, I think I would shoot an entire roll in this style out on the street in similar lighting. I'd skip the lab scans and just do it myself at home. So let's focus in on that a bit, because I think that's what can cause trouble with some of these alternative film stocks. Lab scanners are usually calibrated for common films that have an orange base, whereas films like this and others have a greenish base that doesn't scan as well. The lab scans I got weren't bad by any means, but you can look at the side-by-sides later and decide what you prefer. So to digitize the roll myself, I tried the Negative Supply Basic Carrier Mark II with their new Light Source Basic Mark II. I used the Canon 5D and 100mm macro as usual, and NLP 2.3 for the conversion. I found that NLP did quite well with the batch conversion, and I didn't have to make too much of an adjustment to the frames. The main adjustments I did make were to brighten some of the snowy scenes to compensate for all the white in those frames. I found a more pleasing saturation and tonality in the NLP scans personally. Less of a green cast and better detail in many shots. They weren't too different overall, but there seems to be a bit more room for adjustment in the camera scans, as expected. It also handled that intentionally overexposed frame a bit better, retaining more of the highlight detail than the lab scan. As for the underexposed shots, it did give a bit more range, but of course, couldn't rescue an overly thin frame on the negative. So these are my results from NC500. They kind of grew on me over time. I have a feeling that it's the same stock as the new Lomo 92, or perhaps something similar brewed up at the Innovascope factory. I like it more than Lomo Metropolis, for example, and only wish that the grain was a bit smoother. If you want a deeper analysis and more of a background on Orwo and this film and the alternatives, I highly recommend checking out the channel Analog Resurgence. Noah has a great channel there that gives insightful information and tests on this and many other film stocks. So what do you think? Would you try it? I might eventually give another roll a shot. I want to thank my friend Darren who sent me this roll, and he's become kind of like my supplier and dealer of new and exotic film stocks, even though I'm quite late to the game on trying them and sharing my results sometimes. So thanks for watching, and check out the links in the video description for ways that you can support the channel if you feel like it. I'll see you in the next one.